Hey Stefan and Muffin. You got Captain Bly to 5-star already, Stefan. That's pretty good. I haven't started yet, so I don't know how hard it will be. So how is the event? Event is good, that sounds great. I think they slowly are getting worse and worse. Hey Papa Franco, you got by to 4.1-star. That's also nice. There was one dude on my Discord that posted that the hat wheel, he got 3 jackpots in one spin. I mean, in whatever it is, 10 spins or 11 spins. That looked very cool. Oh, that was you, Stefan. Okay. 3 jackpots in one spin. That was the old one. Leaderboard. Some Apex dude is number one. And there's a Rice guy on number three. Sixty spins and four jackpots. How many? What's the percent chance? What's the chance of getting jackpot? So for 60 spins you should get one or two on average. Okay, it sounds like normal 2-3%, so you have to get pretty lucky to get a lot. I'd be happy if I can get him to 5-star. Okay, so let's see in here. Login token. Also buy gold tickets for hats. Probably not a good idea. Some swords. Need 3 swords. That's not very good. This is Mutiny, Mr. Christian. Is that from the cartoons? I guess it is. Naval reatomizer. Okay. The normal one. Seagoing Sam is a good tune. I also think this Captain Bly, he looks really powerful with that crazy skill with the 100% attack and turn meter. We have R&D also. Captain Bly on hard mode on R&D, okay. Which R&D is it this time? I hope it's not conditions apply. I don't like that one. It's supposed to be some keys also. Tiklus has great value on the golden ticket wheel. It looked a little bit like always. Yeah, Captain Bly is only on the jackpot, so 2% chance of getting him. The rest, I don't know. I have almost all of them on max rank. There's only 2 tunes I can use. I don't think that's worth spinning. Then we have, oh, we can spin this one. Thank you. You have added value with event premium objectives. Oh, like in the super event. I'll go have a look. Why is it just one every time? Jackpot on this wheel. It can only give two tune pieces. What a silly jackpot. Then we have this one here, hat wheel. It's the same, there's only two tunes I can use. So what is it? Cucurator is 10% and Fire Poggy is 17 and 3. So I have 30% chance of getting something that is not overshot. So let's go in here. Start here. That took exactly 10 minutes. My most powerful team, it's Black Knight, Grand Duke, Box the Brave, and Merlin Sam. It's around 100,000. Maybe 99. First crash, well done. Yeah, well. One of these we can open also. See if we can get a new one. $100,473. Unlock Bly through the campaigns and the sword exchange. That sounds good. Because my luck lately for getting jackpots, except for the Looney Wheel, I got a lot of those two-piece jackpots, has not been so good. But hopefully today is the day. Okay, let's claim all this stuff here. Oh, I have to level up someone also. The normal quest. Event quest. So there's collect tune pieces up to 8,000. Then we have regional materials. I got 18 so far. Quite a bit of energy here. What is that? 375 energy. Premium quests. Okay, here we have that spin the wheel again. So maybe it's worth it spinning the wheel, but I just think since almost all the tunes are maxed, maybe not. But yeah, there is a lot of added value here. Secret stuff, a lot of skulls, golden skulls. Spin the ticket wheel 300 times. Oh, there's some more of those. I probably shouldn't claim those yet. This one. Ah, there's a fortune up to the next milestone. Guess we have an alliance crate also. So how do you get swords? I guess it comes from campaign. You got two jackpots for 48 tickets, that's pretty good. Pretty good. Just see here, so I only have two of those. Goodness, there's a lot of battles. It's 25. It's 100 battles. Okay. That's gonna take a little while. You go to all the campaigns with a Bly at level 1, okay. Yeah, that sounds like they're pretty easy then. Hey, Machika, I guess it is. And Jonathan, please, welcome. What is the bonus campaigns? Bonus battles, okay. That's those where you can use, we only have a few tools. Well, we can't do those yet. Let's just start from the beginning. Does it matter if you 3-star those? I seem to remember last time it didn't matter too much. It depends if you need one to replay them, of course. New event is coming. Well, there's two new events every week. I kind of like the graphics of that Captain Bly. Botox lips and the big pot belly. Oh, this one gives a sword. So it's like last time, you can replay the last battles for a chance of a sword. Yeah, I think this is a copy of the... There was another one that's very similar. Lots of paper pieces. Is your friend will be here? I think you are asking if Nikolaus is coming. He said maybe, but he was cooking dinner or food anyway. So he was busy, but he might come later. This is gonna cost a fortune in energy. 100 battles, what, wonder what the average is, maybe 10 or 15. That'll be a lot of energy. Yeah, I guess, Stefan. If I get enough hats, I will spin it. Oh, you are guaranteed a sword in the first clear, okay. And then it's a 10% chance for a sword in repeat battles. What was this here? 5% chance. I wonder if I haven't run out of energy. Better wait with those repeat battles until we finished some of this. Yokai Tess is coming soon, that's correct. So 5, 10, 12. Yeah, there's a new update coming out. I have it here somewhere. Link to it somewhere, but there is a new update coming out with the team synergies. They talked about it before, so I guess when you put your team together, you can see how many blue hearts and other stuff they get. But any events where I can use 4 Avalone tunes is gonna be easy. I mean, 4 of the ones that I actually have, 7 star, because I have all my boosts there. And the team is 88,000. There's no challenge. Maybe there will be in the later modes. Here we're getting 2 swords. So basically what you're saying is it's guaranteed to open this dude. 15 now. Man, I'm already out of energy. This gonna be costly. The ticket wheel is so bad, yeah, maybe, depends. It's purely luck based, no? You got 6 jackpots for 4,000 hats. That sounds very lucky. But congratulations. Yeah, it's right, Stefan. There was some rework of Cachucha Sam and Vampire and Dr. Dorkstein. Energy now. My goodness, this is expensive. So it was 5, 10, 12, 15, 20. You're saying Dorkstein now removes more debuffs? Hello, move. Yeah, I figured that was what you meant, Stefan. You saved 224 golden tickets. That's, I have almost the same, I think. Think I'm gonna use them when they come an abalone wheel that have the tunes that I have in abalone that is 5-star. That was everything. Start in here. Maybe. Where's all the other quests? Oh, now they're there. A little bit of energy and a gold chicken. And some secret stuff. Oh yeah, that one I can't do right now. And it takes ages to load this. I guess it must be here. Got 9 swords. Well, it spins. It's all over shards. Look, there was something good there. Curator is nice. Actually, it was an okay spin because 5 of them were not overshots. What do we have here? Bit more of goodies. Morning Drake. Medium. Well, Stefan, that's actually quite, that's 3 weeks ago now. I was got very lucky with jackpots in one of the events. But after that, I have been getting below average number of jackpots. Except for that loony wheel that keeps two pieces of Outback. I hit jackpot almost every time I spin it. But since it only gives two pieces, then who cares? Come on, move. You got handmaiden from 5-3 to 7-7 from this event. Where do you get handmaiden? Anyway, handmaiden is very important. It's part of the Stolz install team. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't use my hats on the wheel. Maybe there's something in here that's better. Yeah, you get a lot of pieces. Of course, she's common, but those are all max. The only one I can use it on is Curator. That actually might be better than spinning the wheel. Have him on 6 star, I can probably get him up quite a bit. That is worth considering. Yeah, Captain Bly, he has some crazy skills. First, when I read it, I thought he was gonna be legendary. Yeah, I'm thinking maybe I should max out Curator if I can. 6 star now, actually 6.1 I think. Get 60 to 80 pieces for 100 hats. That should be very doable. And just ignore Captain Bly. Man, there's so many campaigns. Hey, Dart Wayne and B Philly. Machitka. Your clan is the Avengers? Okay. I like the graphic, but that's Captain Bly. The new update, I think they're gonna put those synergy screens in there, so you can see when you build a team if it has synergy bonuses. The rest, I think, is mostly quality of life stuff. I don't think there's gonna come any game-changing update soon. I mean, they just did level 69 and tune up 45. Yeah, I think they talked about that also, Philly. Some kind of forfeit battle button. How can you get Opat? Isn't that one of the featured tunes in the next week? For the next Pat to let in there event? Or maybe, I think Opat was there. Can see it all in the Discord. Five versus five battles. Ah, you mean you can use five tunes in each battle? I'm not sure. It would be hard to get the balance right, but it might be a lot of fun. Minato, I have no idea how you will get Opet. There was someone that said yesterday that when I was streaming that you will be able to toon task Tasmanian toons in the future in around September. They mentioned that one of the, I think it was Leopold mentioned it on the, that Tasmanian toons would be taskable eventually. I didn't see it myself, so I don't know, but someone said. Okay. But someone said that the other Tasmanian toons also would be taskable. I guess not the legendaries, but the epic, common, rare. Yeah, I don't know, Philly, maybe. Yeah, okay, there we have it. Chaotic Lunacy says all Tasmanian can be tasked except legendary ones. In September or so. That will be kind of nice. Yeah, I don't know if I would start boosting Tasmania. I don't think so. Well, maybe once I'm done with Avalone. But that's gonna take quite a long time. I actually think I would rather start boosting in WB Studios. What's your favorite legendary? Box the Brave. But there are many good ones now. But the only one I really use is Box the Brave. Bye-bye, Metchitka. Yeah, town. Yeah, also, I think desert is also good. Hey, Dio. Sure, Darth Vane, I can show my boosts. Special boosts are all in abalone. There isn't anything in anything else. The core boost, when I started, I put something everywhere. Philly, I took all of them up to 5 first in abalone. It's much faster than trying to get 1 to 10. But I started putting level 1 in everything when boost came out, because I didn't really know what I wanted. And it didn't cost anything, they were very cheap. But then I changed to only put in abalone, so now it's 9 attacks, 6 defense, 6 health, and 10 speed. I don't know about these level 10 things, it gets super expensive. 3,500 for just an extra 5% bonus. But maybe it's worth it. I intend to continue anyway, but I'm sure other people say that going more than 7 or 8 is a waste. Hey. What happened there? No, Gio, I haven't unlocked the box yet. What was that? I thought it was just easy, medium, hard. But I can only use one tune. Okay. Well, I don't think they can kill my Pepe. Yeah, I know you can toon task Captain Bly. Man, if you have a bad Pebble Bot, then this would be horrible. Wonder what I can use here. Pepe and Grand Duke. They kind of hit my strongest tunes. Yeah, Philly. Yeah, it's because Pep is so boosted. When I'm using Kitty Katie and Pepe and some other tunes in an event, even if the other ones are attackers, Kitty Katie will call Pepe because he has more attack than my attackers from other regions. My Cupid, okay. Cupid, my Cupid isn't that strong, I think. But it works. Install teams. Muffin, there's lots of people on that watching. The number goes between 30 and 35 at the moment. Yeah, Cupid don't usually work that well alone. So let's see what we can use here. It's all my strong tunes. Okay. This will be very easy. That day was his day, yeah, maybe. I do use Cupid a lot in when I run stall teams. McNick, he said he was cooking. He was busy with cooking or something. He might be coming later. Just keep some lie pieces. I have 56 pieces now. So 66 pieces now. And let's see what we can use here. Oh, now I need him. Yeah, this should be enough, actually. Which toon is the most annoying one to defeat? Muffin. I don't know. Starfarrow can be a bit of a headache. Get 60 to 80 pieces here. I think that's very well, very much worth it. $1.6 million. My goodness. Oof. Me, I would choose, if I had could get 100 epic pieces, I'd probably have choose Seagoing Sam or Canasta. Cannoneer Canasta or whatever his name is. I'll definitely choose someone in Tasmania. This is mutiny, Mr. Christian. Okay. While the game boots, I will be right back. Thank you. Hey, Aditya Supreme. Going for 1 million gems, I don't know. Screenshots or jackpots all with two or more. Okay. Yeah, that's crazy. Hey, D-guy? D-K? I'm not sure. Hey, Ranjan, Jonathan Place, when is the next giveaway? Well, I just did one yesterday. Sometime in August. You're going the exchange route, Philly? Yeah, I think I'm gonna buy Curator from the rest of my hats, I think. Swords you can exchange in the for blight pieces. Stop jumping. Lots of overshots.
Arriba, arriba!
Get the offshore.
Nine more pieces for the next star fragment. Can I show Tournament of Mayhem? Yes. Hey, Ricky Morgi. My goodness, again. You got 7 jackpots. I'm using an iPad to play on, not iPhone. I don't know about that, Philly, but it is a bit odd that Black Knight Sam is not a knight. Thank you. 3.1. Last battle. If I also can use Grand Duke and Merlin Sam here, then it's gonna be quite easy. Six swords. Yeah, I think Gio, I think they're experimenting. Some players get gems and some players get energy for the videos. Hey. Whatever your name is. That's that one, so let's see what we can use here. Now it's Merlin. Takes quite a while to beat all these battles. Yeah, Vicky Mochi. Been at it for 1.5 hours now. I'm not done yet. Well, Stefan, that might work, but not with a 3-star tune in arena. That's suicide. Thank you. Now we can use those two. Yeah, Baku, I got that loony wheel jackpot 5 times now, something I think. 2 pieces of a tune. It's not really here. What I would call generous. Jackpot buddies. Okay. You have here 2 tanks. See here. Okay, now I can use all of them. I think this Captain Bly is almost legendary. His skills are quite powerful. Is the new Taz the Yokai Tess, I guess. I think he's epic, I'm not completely sure. Be enough energy. So that's everything, and all the battles can be replayed for chance of sorts. Let's try this again. Actually, no. No head wheel. I don't think it's worth it. You think it's sad? Well, another sword. Hmm. 200 gems. And again. I think I'm gonna take Curator up to 7-7. Yeah, well, if I'm lucky with the wheel and get some jackpots, then I will get maybe a 5-star Captain Bligh. But if I use the hats on the exchange, then I'll get a 7-star Tasmanian Tune. That's better, no? I think, anyway, let me just check. Well, maybe check. Hello. I think it's better to get a guaranteed 7-7 star tune. Yeah, but I will not quite get there. There we have Nikolaus. Hey.
Hi there.
We were just talking about what I should use my hats on. I'm thinking taking Curators of 7-7.
Yeah, I don't know. What are the options?
Well, Curator is Oh, the other ones here are maxed, so never mind. But the other option is the wheel.
Yeah, I can only tell the wheel is very, very. If you really wanna have a curator or don't mind having him, go for the wheel. He comes very, very often, at least for my taste.
Yeah, but then I'm probably gonna end with a 5-star Captain Bly and maybe a close to 7-star curator. It's not.
Yeah, the other stuff is seems you have maxed them, yeah.
Yeah, I'm missing a few Friar Porgy pieces.
Yeah, but they come by windfall because they get it every day. So it's only
curator. So it's the only reason to spin the wheel is for the 3% chance of Captain Bly. I spun the wheel,
and I ended up with a shitload of curator pieces.
Yeah, well,
I can already. And just read it was the odds are only 10% for me, at least 50% at least.
I got him two times from 22 spins.
Okay. Yeah, for me, 11 spins and 6 times, 7 times the rate.
Okay.
No joke. Yeah. For these missions with tomb pieces, also the wheel is good. Yeah.
You're making noise.
The usual noise. So starting up my phone. I would give the wheel a chance, but I can understand your.
I'm gonna do the curator pieces until he's maxed, and then there's gonna be around 10 more wheel spins probably when the whole thing is over. Of course, I could wait. I could do the wheel first and then tomorrow, and the rest of the tournament I could do the tune pieces, the exchange, because I will get more hats now, so I don't know if I will get enough though.
You notice that Captain Bly is taskable.
Yes.
So it's the first Tasmanian which is taskable.
But they also said that all the Tasmanian will be taskable in September.
Yes, I would want to say that. So he's only the first, or the others. So, yeah, for me it's not good news because.
Well.
But in general, you already know it's overdue. Simply, it's overdue. That's so odd. I mean, there was some kind of justification when Tasmania tunes really stood out a bit and were significantly stronger than other stuff. But with the recent new tunes, I don't think so. That the Tasmania region is distinct better than any other region.
I think there's a few regions that are worse. Particular space.
Yeah,
but there's farm a lot that are good.
Yeah.
Summit got a lot better with Lola.
Yeah, there's also that also, and now there will be this space Marvin path of legendary. So the other regions eventually will catch up a bit, and Avalune was pushed hard. Desert is featured well. WB will come for sure in the future, in the forthcoming future. So really, I don't see really a justification to handle tune tasking exempt in Tasmania anymore.
No.
So overdue, cool stuff. If it had from the beginning, would have made stuff much easier for me.
Yeah, toontasking. Yeah, well.
Yeah, really. I have some types of now some Tasmania toons where I lack three pieces here and five pieces there or stuff. Yeah. Okay, one is legendary, so the problem would also be solved. And so, but yeah, Captain Bly's face is really the funniest thing that I ever have seen. I don't know. I remember the classical film Mutiny on the Bounty, and if I look at the face of this Bugs Bunny, it reminds me on Orson Welles. I don't know if he was in the classical movie.
I don't know, but I do like the tune, the picture or whatever you call it. I like the dude. He looks fun.
Yeah, fun? I don't know. He looks quite. He's in a bad mood.
Yeah, he's definitely in a bad mood.
And look at that, those lips, those look a bit like Orson Welles. I have to look it up.
Ah, Stefan, you're saying the only regions without legendary is WB and Desert? Yeah.
No. Farm has a legendary? Which one?
I'm not sure.
I don't think Farm has one.
No.
No legendary.
Summit has Hugo, Space has Star Power, yeah, okay.
Please, no desert legendary. Yeah, I think there are regions who need legendaries more than others. And I think desert can hold on its own. On its own. For sure. Hard-hitting tunes. And fast. So. Farmer has Petunia. Ah, that might be. Is Petunia a farm tune? As farm Petunia there is, but is the OG Petunia isn't farm, or is she?
There's this one, but that's not, I think it's abalone, isn't it?
Yeah, the farm Petunia is a common.
I don't know where it is.
Maybe town, or town or city, town I guess.
This one. It's a town.
Okay.
I don't know. Is this tune any good?
I think it is. She's not bad, but for a legendary, she is. For a legendary, she's. She's a good count. To me, appears she is a good epic, but not an outstanding legendary. I mean, this evaluation can sometimes change if new tunes come out and suddenly there is some kind of synergy ongoing.
The game is really in a crashing mode today. I think that was sixth time.
Oh dear.
Or fifth time.
Oh dear. So. This Alliance Looney tournament is quite tricky with when to collect the milestones.
Yeah, I definitely did it wrong.
I mean, it becomes a little bit more easier later because yeah, it's capped at 6, and if the one single milestone is 4 or greater, so it's easy to add them up to the 10 to do the favorite yeah, 10, the favorite last battle. But if you claim too early, it really hurts you. So hopefully I get some kind of tick here. Where we go? Since when are you online? Quite a while now, yeah.
Streaming, you mean?
Yeah.
2 hours.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, I was late. I had to do some cooking. The new name of the game is Lunar Crash, yes. To be honest, I it's relatively stable for me. Sometimes it's a little bit of getting stuck and then goes on again, but really crashes I don't have. Crash World of Mayhem, yeah. Crashes cause mayhem also. I found a way, but with my tools, to score good versus the watch team. I changed the kill order a bit and managed the double bombs, and that increases outcome significantly. Yeah, 9-6-2-2 is a very good score.
This might be a little harder. Let's see. I don't think he's... Yeah, it looks very strong. I actually think it's two players because they were there already when I went in. But they don't have any
titles. Not necessarily. Look at that. That's definitely a player. NRW1 means that's North Rhine-Westphalia. That's basically a kind of state county in Germany. It happens, I stem from there. Yeah, and Pale Rider is, I think, a famous Clint Eastwood western. Pale Rider.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Actually, I pretty much love the Clint Eastwood westerns. They are great.
We also have this thing today.
Yeah. Maybe we should do, or you should do that, ask for team chat suggestions. Because otherwise it's boring, because there is a usual combo and press auto. So perhaps we can make something more out of it.
Usually I just use the tanks. Basically, just Foghorn, Hector. Maybe those three that are featured, or it doesn't really matter. It's quite easy.
Yeah, I recommend the stall team plus OG Hector. So you can do it with three commons and a rare. Press auto.
Okay, I haven't tried using stall team and Hector.
Yeah, maybe give it a try.
Stefan is suggesting Captain Bly, Sam Sheepdog, Box the Brave, and Cupid Elmer.
Yeah, well, why not? Yeah,
it probably works.
Think around a bit. And the funny thing really is three of the four RD, basically all besides this somewhat tricky conditions apply, can be solved with stalling with a change in form. So if you max out three commons, and then you can do them all in all stages. Stall team OG Hector is this one, best defense. Stall team plus OG Granny is overtime. Stall team plus chauffeur Porky, so you even have a team of four commons, is up to speed. That's basically the most economic solution to the R&D riddle.
Yeah.
I think new, I mean not so new, Lola Frostbane is very good. Yes, she is. And once she, you will come across... boost the Frostbanes and tune Frostbanes, and she will be a pain in the ass. For sure.
This team might work, but it's not like it gets a lot of defense up. But of course, at turn 3 I can do that crazy skill with him.
Yeah, that's I thought OG Hector is a better choice. I mean, if you try for the best defensive, I would certainly include OG, OG Hector I would include, Grid Iron Gossamer, and Foghorn. Those
yeah, that's the feature. That's the features ones. Now we can try this skill. I haven't tried it before. So everybody gets 100% turn meter and 50% attack.
Yeah, that looks nice. Yeah, the animation is quite unspectacular. It's spectacular. Just a little lightning.
I need to use taunt on everybody first, okay? You can try that. Even on him? Okay, it gives a lot of defense up, that's correct.
It is the team I got past hard mode. Yeah, as I said, with stall team, just press auto. But yeah, if you use that, and it makes it very, very boring. So I think experimenting a bit is the better choice.
Seems to work. I'm not so sure how it will go in hard mode with my 3-star Captain Bly.
Once I could say, even with a 3 or 4-star, he seems quite sturdy. I think I played through the campaigns, he wasn't beyond 4-star.
Still working.
I can imagine maybe it's one of those things which may work better in the later stages. I had Enforcer, so that may be helpful. The key is flipping, yeah.
Works.
Is there actually a cartoon for this Captain Bly? I could imagine, but I can't remember if I saw that.
What do you mean, if there's a tune?
Cartoon. I mean, especially the early classic ones, the tunes, you can really identify from which movie they stem from. The Masked Avenger has one. Sheriff Porky has one, Nasty Canasta has one, and stuff.
This team worked really well, actually. Even with a 3-star dude in there.
Thank you.
Yeah, Stefan, that worked very well, actually. I didn't think I could beat an insane level with a 3-star tank, but it worked.
Yeah, it's quite, as I said, quite sturdy, and yeah, there's lots of heal available. Yeah, actually convincing. Well done.
One battle that was a 2-star here.
And the final one.
Yeah, okay, that's not gonna be better this time. he died before he moved.
A little bit disappointing, my love. Before you got the chance to move, you know it will be 2-star. Yeah, okay, sorry for laughing. Okay. It was kind of funny. Yeah, this heal to max is very, very useful.
If they do it again.
Well, this time not.
No, but now it went a little different, but okay, maybe it will work. That was a little lucky. I think we can kill tourists now.
Yeah, that will help.
With the box, one shot him. Okay, it might be a little hard to get this one 3-star. Not that it is a big deal, but still.
Yeah, it itches a bit. Only a bit.
So is this curator actually any good? I never use him.
Many people say no. And actually I quite often use him in war. Because he's actually not the best tools, but he has an interesting kit.
Removing stun, that sounds kind of nice.
Yeah, and he has an AoE attack, that's also nice. Inflicting 1-2 random debuffs, stun the target enemy, also good.
And he gains turn meter if someone gets stunned, so he can use his stun to cleanse him. And 2 stat down, that's actually also okay. 2 stat down on all enemies for 3 turns.
Yeah. So on paper it's not bad. So yeah, for arena defense he's too squishy. He's clearly a weak point. But he also, if you're lucky, you get counter up or stuff, and so yeah, it's a bit of a wonder back, yeah. Yeah. It's for sure not the absolute best tool in the whole rooster, but not the baddest or the worst either. How many treasure chests do you get from the campaign in the first run?
What do you mean? How many I open?
This swords, or what is called, or sabers, or I don't
think
know.
I opened 25 treasure chests, so I mean, at least there's available 975, and I think they started at 1,000.
999, I think, like the others.
The others started at 1,000.
Yeah, okay, maybe then. So 25, so 75. Oh, that's good.
I did spend a little bit on replaying. I got a few from replaying, some leftover energy.
Yeah. I think it's a considerable amount. So it is. It's always five pieces of Captain Bly.
Yeah, you're guaranteed to open him. And Marushi also. Max Curator. And there was one earlier that maxed Handmaiden by using these. It gives a lot of pieces now.
Yeah, I don't know if that's necessary, but because you can task Handmaiden normally, you can't do that with the Curator. And normally, she should drop quite often.
It used to be you got it always, but the dude in the chat said he started at a 5.3 Handmaiden and have a 7.7 now.
Okay, yeah.
That's a boost.
Hi Mandara and McNicholas, how are you doing? Thoughts on the new event? I was able to max here, okay. Yeah, I think the new event is quite okay. Can't complain. I mean, as always, I would like the luck factor being diminished, or some better odds for the wheel for getting by a bit. But maybe it's a more micro problem with lots of max tunes, so we're always getting overshots. On the other hand, I think the tune is cool. You get a reasonable amount. You can do lots of that wheel spins, and yeah, can't complain. It's okay, kinda. I mean, some of the missions are a bit really over the top, spinning 300 times a wheel. So that's also again, yeah, say 600, 700 gold tickets. That's a bit much for my taste. What I like, there is quite some opportunities to get some secret stuff and some tune related stuff, or high tune related stuff. So I'm very, very okay with that. You can get actually as much superior region material, so that you don't need to necessarily farm a lot of those traits. So if you, for example, have bought the Brawl Pass, you can focus on this trade trackers stuff. Would you use my team, McNicholas? Yeah, for sure, I can use that. I said I'm a lazy guy sometimes. If I know I have a team combo that I can fail-free use and on auto, then I will do that sometimes. Do you have a good suggestion at defense in arena? It's hard to tell. At defense down R&D. Yeah, it's. I recommend the classical stuff. It's Scarecrow, Labard, Outlaw Sylvester, and Desperado Dog. That's what works. But you need some trying. I know there are combos around recommended with Dogsteen and with Speedy Gonzales, but I found them hard to handle. Yeah, also Captain Blige is a taskable for Tootles. Yes, I mentioned that. And that's, I appreciate that, but that's cool.
Does he have a new building, or is it an existing one?
It's in a existing one. It's in the, because there is where basically where Canasta and Seagull Sam live. It's kind of this ship wreck in Tasmania region.
Okay.
He's not there. It's fitting. That fits. Yeah, though not 100%. Those ones are pirates. He's the antagonist in a way. So, but yeah, fluff wise, it fits. What's your opinion on the new Imperials? Yeah, they seem very strong. But that seems also recently, with all the new tunes, they really seem, yeah, a bit... The kits seem a bit more powerful than the kits of the classical tunes.
Yeah, I think it happens in most games, actually. They release tunes that are a little bit better than the one that was there before, all the time.
I mean, it reminds me, I don't know if many of you look long-time soap operas. Yeah, like crazy hard stuff. Sometimes that lasts over years, sometimes even over decades. And it all starts totally harmless. And in the end, it's always rape, pillage, burning, murder. So kind of... I seem as this the long ongoing stuff has an intrinsic logic of tending to escalate. That's my impression. Yeah, Stefan Dumitrescu says that it's the pirate ship building. Yes. I hope you have developed that already.
I build all the buildings.
Me too.
I think I build all the buildings. Unless I missed some by mistake, but usually when a new building come out, I build it right away.
I can remember in the first year of the game, and yeah, I think only recently stopped. There were lots of discussions. If developing buildings is worth the resources put into it.
Maybe not, but...
I don't think I'm heavily leaning, so that pays off greatly.
Yeah, but you don't have to build all the buildings, especially the Tasmanian ones are kind of silly.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Should be ready. Hey, that's the same team two times.
I think that's bots, yeah.
Oh, one of them is a bot, I think, and the other one is just a copy of his team.
Yeah, you can sometimes you get those mirrors, and it's really annoying. Do you know what archetype passive means? Yeah, I think that's a new concept, so that the new tunes sometimes have additional stuff. Yeah, that's maybe an archetype. It was normally say such thing as being a defender or being an attacker also. Yeah, there's one aspect I don't like about this event. It's very energy hungry because of the sheer number of brawls you have to do. That could be a close call, couldn't it?
This one I'm not sure I'm winning.
Do you think it's worth it to spin the ticket wheel 20 times for 48 golden tickets? Yeah. Have a long, deep look in the missions. And calculate beforehand which ones do you want to fulfill. I think the most of the players won't fulfill the 300 spins and stuff. But maybe you want to go to the 20, maybe you want to go to the 60, maybe you want to go to the 40. Decide that beforehand and then spin the wheel, but don't expect to get much jackpots from the wheel because the odds are not good. So if you do it for the missions. Yeah, so don't be disappointed because otherwise you may. Yeah, for, to make it more concrete, I went for a certain point and said it beforehand and spun a lot of. I spun multiple 20 times and I never got Captain Light. So that may happen.
But, so this one is the one you're talking about, how many should...
Yes, yeah. You should decide before him where do you want to go. So 48 tickets guarantees you the stuff up to making waves 5.
Is it worth it?
Yeah, it's 60 secret stuff. Not bad. It's some kind of... Two unique carrots, two unique materials, oh, that's also okay. And you get 35, 55, 85, 90, 130 Captain Bligh pieces. Anyway, and 5 tune-up ticks. Okay, let's look further. Further down.
25 tune-up tickets.
Yeah, 75, 20, yeah, tune up to get 75 more things, more secret stuff, more carrots, and a huge, and a considerable amount of Captain Bligh pieces. So, I'd recommend, if you're really, really going hard, go to the 60. And if you don't want to go not so hard, go to the 45. Yeah, or but don't expect to do so much from the wheel spin itself. That will help greatly with the tune collecting missions and stuff. But basically, you do it for this stuff. What's in the missions?
Yeah, I don't really know if it's really a good idea. Brawl pass. They're still not finished. Oh, now they are. Well, okay.
Yeah. I think it's a matter of question if it's really worth it. You have to decide for yourself. You could also say, oh, okay, I say just save the tickets.
Yeah, I don't. I think the wheel is so bad that I will only get overcharged mostly.
Yeah.
So I don't.
Yeah. I got jackpot from 5 spins. Yeah, okay, may happen also. You may spin this stuff with 48 tickets and have 5 jackpots. May happen. I spun it a lot, multiple 20 times, and I got nothing from it. Always only overshot. So, but somewhat I had the mindset of knowing beforehand, so I really decided to do it for the stuff in the mission. If you want to grow a Captain Bligh, I think the normal wheel, the currency wheel, is good enough. There's quite some amounts of jackpots dropping.
But it's just 3%, but yeah, you get a lot of spins, of course.
Yeah. Yeah, Supreme says the same. I didn't get any there with 2 spins, but I did get light to 7.2 with Head's Wheel Farming Campaign. Yeah, my expression also, that gives a lot, and there are lots of milestones, and add the missions up to it. I think, yeah, it's okay. I think this whole stuff, what you can use in this event, works okay together for the most people. I said the only drawback is farming the heads is very energy intensive because Basically, yeah, you have good, relatively good odds in most of the campaigns, and so you really wanna farm all of that, and that's very energy hungry.
No, it's actually here. 20 spins is 48 tickets. Okay.
Yeah, it's not so terrible priced. I mean, that's 2.5 for one spin, so it's okay. Yeah, but as the odds are not so good, and probably you don't need the other stuff. Really, you do it for the secret stuff. Yeah, I got lots of jackpots on the head wheel. Yeah, I think that one is quite okay. Maybe even better than the odds described.
Yeah, I don't know if I should spin it.
For me, I think you should decide beforehand. For me, I'd say it's sensible to spin, say, up to the 60. So add up for the 60 and compare if it's okay to spend, 96, 100, 144 gold tickets for it.
Yeah, I think it's better for me to wait.
Yeah.
I do like those 25 tune-up tickets.
Yeah, for sure. And there is additional secret stuff and Merlin stuff and really a lot of skulls and carrots.
Yeah, need skulls and carrots. It doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is the tune pieces and secret stuff and the tune-up tickets.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, really. Yeah, okay. So, yeah.
I think it's better because it's hard for me to replace 148 gold tickets.
So be it.
Brawl Stars, okay. Okay, it's a Dutch team, they're quite low in power.
Yeah, well, okay, that doesn't help. I think putting up Dutch teams on defense is at the moment all the rage. And two variants, one with Zootsuit and one OG Roadrunner. Yeah, 25 tune-up tickets. 25 tune-up tickets may get you to heaven in this game or gave you utter worthless shit. Both in it. I mean, if you spin five times and get five times a jackpot for secret stuff, it really, really helps you and may up you get blue boosters.
9-7 against the Dutch team.
Yes. And I, with my suggestion from yesterday, I managed today 9-9-7.
9-7, I think that's the highest I got, but they were too weak. I managed to get 3 bombs.
Yeah,
they were just too low level.
Great stuff.
This is my own team.
You Seeger and an Outlaw. Yeah, that may work also. Sometimes I shy away from using Outlaw because he's a bit squishy. But maybe if at some point I have a little bit of overflow from secret stuff, I really consider him building him up again, and then he should be viable. Yeah, at the moment I'm building on my Tasmania tunes for tunes beyond 30. Hi Brian Coates, hi Mendega, hi McNicholas. Did you unlock Captain Bly yet? Yes, I did.
And yeah, so me too. If you can win the campaigns, you get him automatically.
Didn't Which I is nice.
No, 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 no. Damn it.
Again.
It was going okay.
Yeah, you have no defender on board, man. Yeah, the defender is the three star. Okay, I get it.
Hey, Smokey.
Hi, Smokey.
Fifth time was lucky one.
Yeah, not this one. I haven't got the jackpot yet. Yeah, we need it. Not on the gold ticket wheel, but I have several jackpots on the head wheel also. I got the 300 jackpot, 150, and two of 125. Yeah, that adds up. So you should be at least at five stars. Captain Bly is fat, yes. And his back is swelled up a bit. So from an orthopedic standpoint, not okay how he stands there.
Also
when you see him standing, sorry.
Oh, I was just talking to myself. Basically, I wasn't sure if you could get swords in the last one.
In last every game. Last one, in every last one, you get. So it makes sense farming those swords. When you see him standing, his stomach just looks fat, though. Yeah, yeah. I also think he has a. Yeah, a problem with his holding, not necessarily with his weight. Yeah, you noticed that for some players, watching the ad gives energy instead of gem.
Yeah, someone told me. I haven't actually tried. But I don't want to click it while I'm streaming. It still says 3 gems on mine, but I don't know if it gives energy now.
Yeah, for me it just gave 13 energy. That's quite good. Okay, that would be 65 for 50. Okay, it's a little bit less value, but yeah, you can only do it 4 times a day, 50. So
I'm only missing 900 pieces now, so that's so we don't have to. I don't have to go all the way to 77 because I can spend the hats here and then probably get something, some cool raider pieces. My goodness. I don't know what's going on today, but it really crashes a lot. And I did all the stuff before the stream about restarting the closing, shutting off the iPad and booting it again and all the stuff, so it should be clean and ready. And it just keeps going.
Yeah. Alex Lopez Guzman, the wheel of tickets should be spin. Well, 50 for one golden ticket instead of 25 for 12 golden tickets. Yeah, I agree totally. I would, if you send me a petition to subscribe to and send it to Scotland, I will subscribe. I support that.
So let's see if we can get some jackpots here.
Yeah, should
so
I leave
I spun
again?
It, spun it two times. Yeah, I did it two times in the beginning of the stream. So this is number three times. So there should be a jackpot on average here. At least I'm getting Fire Porgy. That's better than Overshots.
Just said and only Overshots occurred.
At least these are baloney overshots, so I can probably use them at some point.
Yeah.
Just to find some positive thing. Three usable. Four actually, that was also curator. And I have 70% chance of overshots, so that was average, I guess.
Yeah, so not too bad.
But still no jackpots.
Also not been on this one.
No, it didn't look like it. Hopefully curator then.
Yeah, I don't know if I got the screenshot, but I think I had one time I had 88 curator in it. And it was of course overshot. So I wasn't amused.
Here was 10 overshots out of 11. And still no, that was 44 rolls at 3% chance and no jackpot.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw lots of screenshots, people having one or two in one spin.
There was one that showed on my Discord, there was one with three jackpots in one spin.
Yeah, okay, or even that, yeah, so.
I think that was actually Stefan.
Yeah, maybe.
In the chat. No, I lost my jackpot luck. There was two events in a row where I got a ton of jackpots. And ever since then, I've been way below average.
I wish we can see Nikolaus' screen, yes? Yeah, I hope one day it will happen. That we can do it that way, that we are both our streamers. Confess, Mac Nikolaus. What should I confess? All the things I regret in life could be a long, long story.
It would be a long, long story. And it looks like, again, no jackpot. So that was 66 spins and no jackpot. That's, it's too random.
I told you before, go for the exchange.
No, what? But I already, it's already 7.4, so I will have enough. Curate is 7.4, so I'll get the rest. I can just get them the last day from the exchange.
Yeah.
I just wanted it somewhat close. And I got a bit more here. Yeah.
Oof, no jackpot at all. Yeah, I think that's a little bit below. One or two should have been there, at least.
With 66 spins, you should get a jackpot every 33, so yeah, it should have been two.
Yeah.
But curator is missing, what is that, 600, 750 pieces to max.
Yeah, so that should be doable.
I can just do the exchange in the end if I don't get enough. I don't think I have any more arena entries. No. Guess we can do the star crate. 18 minutes. Yep. but it doesn't really matter. It's probably almost over that one. Superior region materials. Maybe I didn't get any more, but I will get 21 tomorrow and 21 on Monday, so it's pretty much done.
What did I wanna do? Ah.
What are you saying? The Poggy exchange is ending today?
Oh, I haven't looked that up.
That would not be so good. Yeah, it ends in 4 hour 40 minutes. Wonder what then will happen.
The problem is sometimes the timer runs out and just renews without the offering being withdrawn.
Well, if it does that, if it disappears, then I probably won't get him to 7-7. Then he will end at 7-4 or 7-5.
Yeah, maybe you could eventually exchange him for the crest at the end of the event, after the event.
Yeah, but I don't have any crests, so that doesn't help. Very few. I think I have 100 left.
Yeah, that's not enough.
Yeah, well, if it ends at 7-4, then tough luck. What was it I wanted to do? I wanted to get my brawl battles done.
Yeah, you said so.
Yeah, Raffin Dorney says that it resets, it doesn't end. I don't know. Maybe.
I don't think so either. It would make no sense, yeah.
Yeah, that's what they usually do, no? They reset every day at event reset, and then you have another 1,000 attempts. Or you can do it another 1,000 times.
I mean, sometimes some things are really odd. You have, for example, you have 24 hours to claim the event rewards. And if you don't do it, they get lost.
But in next time they make the same event, then... Now, what do you mean by event rewards?
Yeah, after the event, before your placement on the leaderboard. You have 24 hours to claim it. And if you don't do that within 24 hours, the rewards are simply lost.
And yeah, they should send it to your mailbox.
Yeah, that's what the most other PA games do. And I don't know why I don't do it here.
Yeah, everybody seems to agree that it doesn't actually disappear, it just resets.
Yeah, there's Dio Vasalia says, read on exchange, it says special offer. So maybe it's time limited. That could be. Up to you to take the risk.
I don't have any more hats, then I have to buy energy for 400 gems a pack.
That makes no sense. That makes no sense. Or you could spin the gold wheel for 20 and get some extra energy, also. I mean...
Yeah. They say they stole my log, and now they're gonna continue with you. Steal your log, I mean. Hey, don't stun him, then the battle takes a lot longer.
At best, slow him down, and it will never end. Time off. Who knows, Magnus? You may be next. Next for what? I have a luck.
Stealing luck.
Yeah, maybe.
Nah, it goes. Some events you are getting more than you should, some events you are getting less than you should. It's just the way it is.
Yeah. I mean, I would love to have a little bit less RNG involved.
Yes.
When, as I said, you spun 66 times and didn't get a jackpot. It's a bit frustrating, isn't it?
The only wheel I always get jackpot on is that that gives two outback pieces.
Yeah, it's a game changer.
I think every time I spun it, I got a jackpot. Or maybe not every time, but at least a lot of times. And the percent chance is not that big.
Yeah, but that doesn't really help you, man. Okay.
Moin.
Yeah, Porky Shane seems worth it. Yeah, then perhaps.
Yeah, I don't know in other events, but it's not that often that it's quite easy to get a 7-7 star to me. Okay, Clara, you're gonna go on timeout with all that spamming in the chat. You can't see it because YouTube is blocking most of it, but
Who is spamming?
Clara Elvis.
Nice stuff or nasty stuff?
Just random letters. 2000 Ks.
So, impatient.
Maybe. YouTube blocks most of it, but it destroys my chat because I can see all the messages. It just doesn't go to the video.
Okay. Use Outback Dog, Kitty Kitty, Black Knight Sam, and Baba Bucks. Yeah, that should work. For sure. What also should work is OG Gossamer, OG Granny, Barber Bucks, and Sales Duck Duffy. That should also work. Good weather's dodge, by the way, also. Maybe not in Arena because of the buffs, but worth a try in Wars.
Yeah, Sales Duck have some special thing there now. I remember there was an event we used him.
Every time the opponent dodges, he gets another attack. So basically it goes back and forth until he hits really, really hard. Yeah, and he hits really, really hard. It's a bit of a risk because not tuned beyond level 30. Yeah, arguably the Sales Duck Duffy is the squishiest tune in the whole Looney Tunes universe.
Yeah, maybe. I remember there was some event where I had to deal with a dodge team. And I used Sales Duck.
Yeah.
And it worked incredibly well.
Yeah, yeah.
I wasn't using him because I thought he was too squishy, and then someone suggested to use him, and then I changed to him, and then it just became easy.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe we try a brawl battle with our team and see how it works.
Cool games. What I was talking about yesterday with the small channels, I was thinking of making a promotional video where each small channel could give me 1-2 minute video clip and I could put them together and then promote all channels in one video. And probably Unstable would help. So maybe you could get a bit more subscribers than, what was it, you hit 50 yesterday, didn't you? So just, I don't know exactly how many small channels there are, but if, say, we could find 5 of them, and then make a, some kind of promotional video where each could do something for a few minutes. That was all I was thinking about. I did ask Unstable about it, and he said that he thought it was a good idea. But of course, we have to figure out... we need to figure out exactly how to do it. But yes, I talked to Unstable yesterday about it. It's basically just an idea to help people a little bit. To get a bit more exposure.
Yeah, you should wait with that until the Pi channel up also.
Yeah, but I think it's never going to happen. We talked about it since last year.
Yeah, that's true. But I will cope with it. Give it. Yeah, next week I'm not at home again. Yes, so it goes. Yeah, in 2 weeks maybe. Thank you. You can try to set it up.
But Cool Games, you can just, if you know some small YouTubers, I think you mentioned one, just send me the Discord or get them to join my Discord or something so I can talk to them. Then maybe we can have a chat about it. Four gems. I know I don't need it, but then it's done.
Now you are gonna get more ambassadors.
Maybe. But that wasn't actually the purpose, it was just to help out a little bit. I remember when I had less than 100 subscribers, it can be very hard to get them. To get a little bit up. This is all done.
Yep.
Got 60 more energy somehow.
Yeah, perhaps you did some efforts. Is in the exchange, is there also some kind of energy?
There is for the swords. The swords give energy.
Yeah, okay.
I don't know if I have enough swords for another crate. May I have 2 actually. It doesn't give a lot, but some.
Okay, turn here, turn there, then there is the loony chest. Yes, that's up.
So you're guaranteed 5 to 10 energy actually, so it's every time.
Yeah, well, yeah, it's actually quite good.
But okay, it's 3 swords, they are not the easiest thing to get, even though they're much easier than they were before.
Yeah, I mean
in those events where there was 1% chance, it was so annoying.
I mean, there was sometimes a sword drop. I don't know which event, but maybe even was the first Samurai Sheepdog event. You just needed 2 to get a title, and I didn't manage that to get that till the end of all the event, not only 2. So yeah, sometimes it. Yeah, really, it's crazy.
Stefan is asking what his main weakness in his team is with for arena defense with Captain Bly, Foghorn the Invincible, Foghorn Leghorn, and Sylvester the Bra.
Yeah, I think putting up Foghorn is, many say it's a sure bomb. Unprotected Foghorn. No go.
Yeah, I would It's okay to have Foghorn Leghorn, so you have early Taunter, but you need something to save him. So I would replace Foghorn the Invincible with Scarlet. So when Foghorn Leghorn gets less than half health, Scarlet will hide him and remove his taunt. So yeah, they have to start attacking another tune.
Yeah, that may help. But otherwise, really, it's Foghorn. Just putting Foghorn on defense, and he isn't probably not strong enough to soak up all the damage and before he moves. And it's all focused on him, and you can't distract him from him. He will probably cause a bomb then.
Yeah, but Sides? if you put
Yeah.
If you put Scarlet in there, then you can sometimes save the bomb.
Yeah. I mean, I use Foghorn on offense. That's quite good. Yeah, but on defense, I don't trust him. But at the moment, really, the defense is tricky. It's really, really tricky. Can't say otherwise.
Yeah, I think the best is probably the Dodge team.
Yeah, Dodge team. I think many people use that. I mean, it can also be broken down, so with high scores. So at the moment, there may be not a safe defense. High Tasmanian is are safe for most, but if you the some of the night teams can really really strap that. It's a bit of a riddle still, at least for me.
Yeah, well, okay, but I think I'm gonna hang up the stream shortly. Been at it for 3 hours. That's enough.
Okay.
And besides, there's no more content. I have no more energy. I have no more anything I can do.
Okay.
There's no the R&D and the event is done. There's no war. So guys, yeah. I think that's it for this time.
Yeah. I say bye also. Till the next time. See ya.
See you guys, Mandagar and McNeilaus out.